Guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Leah, owner of St. Rose and Ray Boutique, and in today's video we'll be discussing episode 2 of Starting Your Online Boutique, the truth behind it. If this is your first time joining me, welcome, thank you. I created my channel just to be an inspiration to other business owners, entrepreneurs out there, to other women, men, whoever that needs inspiration, that needs tips, fashion tips. Just welcoming you all into my life, my daily life. So thank you all for joining and make sure you subscribe to my channel. So in today's episode, we'll be discussing more in detail on how to start up your online boutique and the truth behind it. In the first episode, I discussed all the legal information you would need, all of the, far as with the IRS goes, your EIN number, who you can contact for your, if you want to register as an LLC or a sole proprietor, all that documentation you would need for that. I also discussed the type of vendors and what type of vendors you will want to look for, and how do you find your niche, how do you find your target audience, your market. Discussed about your why. And again, I'm going to talk to you all today about just everything that goes along with starting a boutique, just the real true facts, the real deal about starting a boutique. And again, I'm going to set this again. Please do not depend on everyone to support you. No one is obligated to support you in your dreams and your endeavors. That is what you choose to want to do. If people don't support you, or if they do, so be it. Go for it and do what you need to do. So on today's episode, we'll be going more in depth and talking about when you're selecting your vendors for your clothing store. One of the things I can tell you that you need to do in order to pick the right vendors. I know in the last video I discussed that you all would need your business license or a sales tax number, sales tax permit number, in order to register with every vendor that you will need to purchase wholesale products to. You will not be able to just to purchase them with your name, address, email, or any of that stuff. You will need to have a sales tax number, permit, or a business license in order to purchase from any vendor to show that you are a legit business. And you want to have that information anyway. You don't want to be out here looking like you just doing anything. So when you select your vendors, when you're looking at your vendors, here's the things that you need to really, really, really take into account. First, you want to know where your vendors are located and where your products will be coming from. Why you want to know that is because you want to always have high quality merchandise. You don't want to get products that no one will want to buy, that's cheaply made. You want to get good material, good products that will last people, because, come on, truth be told, people are spending their money on these items. So you want to get good items. You just don't want to pick anything. Think about when you go shopping and the type of clothing that you look for and everything that you look for in your clothing, the quality, the material, if it's going to wash well, if you can wash, if you need to dry clean it. Like, think of all those things when you're shopping for your store. Because you want to keep your customers coming back. You always want to have your repeat customers. And then word of mouth. If you sell good products, think about if you sell good products to people, if you sell great items, and they'll tell someone about your items. So that's also good too for your business, because you want to be able to, you know, have that word of mouth marketing too from your customers. Because it's one thing to get on your website or be on social media and posting different things and posting ads and maybe paying for ads or doing any type of marketing for yourself. But it's another thing when you have people that have really purchased products from you that'll be able to speak to other people for your products as well. So just remember that when you're picking out your products for your customers. And I know I just spoke about marketing and ads. One thing I want to tell you all, when starting an online boutique, you want to have a marketing budget in place. That is one of the things that I made a mistake in not doing. And this is one of the reasons why I created this video here and my channel. Just to be able to help people out there like you that may not know what you need to do, or you know, just to help you prevent you from making the mistakes that I made in starting my business. So you want to have a marketing budget. Of course, you know, when you first start your business, you're just going to think that everything is just going to blow up off the shelf. I know I did. I said, well, I'm going to put these products out here. Oh, everybody's going to love it. I'm going to sell out as soon as I posted my stuff. It was crickets. But I didn't have a marketing budget either. I didn't have an ad budget. I didn't think of those things when I started. I just wanted to start the business. You know, you can be so gung-ho and say, oh, you know, I'm just going to do this. And not that you want to plan, and then your planning turns into kind of procrastination because you want everything to go right and you think everything will go right. It will not. Don't get your mindset that everything's just going to be correct the first time, because in business, you're learning as you go. Each day that you're operating your business, you're learning new things. It's the experience that's teaching you. It's life that's teaching you in your business. But by me telling you all these things, also, it's going to help you along the way so you don't have some of the same hiccups that I had with starting my business. So when you all do that, go ahead, make you a binder. I discussed this in episode one. You want to be organized. You want to be organized starting your business. You want to have everything in place. You just don't want to be all over the place. Have everything organized. In your binder, I discussed about, you know, putting your vendors in the binder. You want to categorize your vendors by their name, what state they're in, what type of products they offer, their price range, and everything. You want to have organization. And speaking of price range, make sure that you know what price you want to charge for your products. One of the mistakes I made when first launching my boutique, I figured that, hey, you know, I don't want to charge this amount because I don't want people to think I'm too expensive. Or you'd be stuck in that place, I don't want to charge a little amount because I don't want people to think I'm cheap either. So you just have to know your market, know your target, and know what you want to do with it. You have to, numbers are important, y'all. Numbers are important. Sit down and really look at the cost of the price that you're purchasing. Once you look at the cost of the price that you're purchasing, then you can know what you're going to charge for your retail pricing. But the smart thing would be to do that I messed up in. I did exactly that. But the smart thing for you to do is to pick your pricing first. Pick your retail pricing first. And then once you do that, then you can go back and say, okay, I'm going to charge retail for this so I know how much I can spend on a wholesaler. Because you don't want to be too high and you don't want to be too low. You want to be just right with your pricing, guys. So, you know, as far as the vendor goes, I know you can do it. I know that it's not a hard thing. It's not a hard task. You all can do it. I will be posting more videos about starting your boutique troop in episode 3. So look forward to that episode. But just keep on researching. Also, I want to talk about this. You can Google any and everything. You don't have to just be in a blind about things. You can Google things and it will come up. Google certain things that you need to know about your business. And also, Google is a great tool to use for business. Google is everything that you need. Google will help you out with your business. So that's one of the things that you can do also. But what I'm going to do is, if you check out my first video, episode 1 of Starting Online Boutique Truths, in the first video I just discussed all the resources that you would need. I will post my email address for you all to email me, and I can send you all the resources again that you all will need to start your online boutique. Is nothing hard about it, guys. You just have to be consistent. You have to be disciplined. You have to know that this is what you want to do. No matter if you have good days or bad days, no matter if you have a sale or you have no sale, a visitor to your website or no visitor, no social media likes, no social media shares, you cannot let that discourage you. You have to have the faith and you have to go on in it and walk in it. Don't let fear stop you all. Don't let fear stop you from doing it, because I know, just speaking from experience, I know that it can be done, because I'm seeing it being done in my life. So that is the reason why I created this video and created this channel, so that I can speak to you all and encourage you and let you know that you can do it. Because I know that I wish that I had someone that knew what I'm telling you all that you can do, just to kind of, you know, stop you all from making some of the same mistakes. Not saying that I know everything. I don't know everything. But I'm learning as I go. And as I learn and as I become an expert in those things, I'm willing to teach it to you all. I'm willing to help you all. I don't look at it as, oh, I need to gain this and gain that. No, God put me on this earth for a purpose. And I know my purpose is to help others out there to realize who they are and realize what they can do. And not saying that we are perfect. I'm not perfect. You're not perfect. But you can do it. You can do it. Just change your mind. Change your mindset. Change the company you keep. Change who you are around. And you can do it. I'm telling you. I'm telling y'all. Like, y'all can do it, guys. Don't let nothing stop y'all. Don't let nothing distract y'all. Don't let your past mistakes, your past failures, don't let that stop you. You can do it. You can do it. And all failure is life teaching you something. Only way you become a failure is when you fail and you don't get back up and try it again. You don't do it. So you failed at that. But you're going to fail. I fail. You're going to make mistakes. I made mistakes. So just get back up and get on it. Don't want to just ramble off about that, but just get back on it, man. You all can do it. You all can do it. I'm going to post another episode 3. Just be more about online boutique truth, starting an online boutique. I just want to tell you all the truth in this. I don't want to show like it's all glamorous and, oh, you know, you're going to make a boatload of money first. I don't want to give you all that perception that happens. It may happen for some people. It may not. Not saying that it can't happen that way. But in the event that it doesn't happen that way, I don't want you all to give up. I don't want you all to get discouraged and give up on your dreams, on your goals, on your visions, whatever they may have. Even if you're watching this video and you don't, and you're not starting an online boutique, you may be just starting a business, or you may just need some encouragement. Man, you can do it. God is with you, and just believe that, and you won't fail. You won't fail. You can succeed at whatever it is that you put your mind to. I know, because I'm living witness, and I'm doing it right now in my life. Right now in my life. Took a leap of faith, started this business, and it's rewarding. I'm able to spend time with my family. I mean, it's just the best. But my faith pushed me there. My faith pushed me there. So don't let fear stop you. Whatever you fear doing, do it. Because once you do it, you're going to be like, oh, I could have been doing this. Whatever you fear, do that. Do that which you fear. It's okay. It is okay. And I am here. You can email me. I am here to just help you all along the way. Any information that I have, that I make and share with you all, I will share it. Anything that I've learned, I'm willing to share it with you all. I'm willing to help you all out there. So don't give up, guys. Keep in it. Keep fighting for it. Whatever your vision is, don't look back. And a good thing to do too, guys, is create yourself a vision board. I know that's something that helped me. It was my first time doing a vision board ever. Never done a vision board. I can remember, though, in elementary school, we used to do, like, the little poster presentations or different things like that of our life. And I guess that would be kind of sort of the same thing now that I'm thinking about it. But created a vision board in the beginning of this year. Created a vision board. Yes, the beginning of this year. And looking at that vision board, so much has come off of it. Man, I would look at it every day and declare over it every day. And once I really start seeing myself doing these things and not letting fear, not letting doubt stop me, God really manifested it. He manifested it because he put everything in us that we need to do anything that we need to do. We just have to believe in who we are in God and not who we feel we may be, or, you know, who we think we are, or those things that we think we can't do. Man, you got to believe what God said about you, that he created you and he formed you in your mother's womb. You were fearfully and wonderfully made. He made you. You are so great. The same person that created Jesus created you. So you have to believe in yourself. Guys, believe in yourself. So thank you all for joining this video. Make sure you subscribe to my channel for more videos to come. Look forward to episode 3. And I will see you guys on the next episode. Y'all have a blessed, prosperous day. Be productive and go be great. Peace.